the camera running? Yes, it is. All right, everybody. This is Rainbow Dash, Rainbow Flash, Rainbow Berry, Rainbow Swirl, Rainbow Wishes, and we're going to be watching The Best of Gordon, my big G. All of us rainbow ponies. Okay, our first story is Gordon takes a dip.
Gordon was resting in the siding. Sometimes he thought, it's really tiring to be such a large and splendid engine. One does have to keep up appearances, so.
Mm-hmm.
Beep, 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 beep. Hello, lazy bones, whistled Henry. What cheek, spluttered Gordon.
That's the same thing Thomas called him.
Wheels. Fancy speaking to me like that. Me, who has never had an accident.
Oh, yeah?
Are jammed whistles and burnt safety valves accidents? Asked Percy.
Oh, yeah, don't they count? Don't they count?
No, indeed. High spirits might happen to any engine. But to come off the rails like Henry did, well, I ask you, is that right? Is it decent? Then it was Henry's turn to take the express. Gordon watched him getting ready. Be careful, Henry. You're not pulling the flying kipper now. Mind you keep on the rails today.
Sometimes Gordon can be a little bit too rude for his own good. That you are right, Rainbow Flash.
Henry went off in a huff, and Gordon yawned and went to sleep. But not for long. Wake up, Gordon, said his driver. A special train's coming, and we're to pull it. Is it coaches or freight cars? Cars, said his driver. Cars, said Gordon.
To this day, Gordon still hates pulling freight trains.
Gordon's fire was slow to start, so Edward had to push
and
Gordon
to this
the
day, he's also very
right
pompous.
Way.
Hey, that's Big G for you. He'll never
go.
Change.
I won't go, grumbled Gordon.
But if he does one day, it'll shock me.
Don't be
big
silly.
Time
Don't
shock
be silly,
me.
Puffed Edward. At last, Gordon was on the turntable. The movement had shaken his fire. It was now burning nicely and making steam. Gordon was cross. It didn't care what he did. He waited till the table was halfway round. I'll show them. I'll show them, he hissed.
Uh-oh. Here comes one of the most historical
he moves
moments.
Forward to jam the table.
And down he
but
goes.
He stop
oh, dear!
Whoosh! He is. Get me out! Get me out!
It's your fault!
Not a hope, said his driver and fireman. You're stuck, you silly great engine. Don't you understand that? They telephoned Sir Topham Hatt. So Gordon didn't want to take the special train and ran into a ditch?
You'd better believe it.
What's that you
yep.
say? The special's waiting? Tell Edward to take it, please. And Gordon, leave him where he is. We'll get him out later.
That's what he gets for not accepting
the
job he's given.
Oh, doesn't he look silly? They'll never get him out. They began to sing. Silly old Gordon fell in a ditch, fell in a ditch, fell in a ditch. Silly old Gordon fell in a ditch all of the Monday morning.
Lame song.
Gordon lay in the ditch all day. Oh dear, he thought, I shall never get out.
Never say never.
But that evening they lifted Gordon and made a road of sleepers under his wheels to keep him from the mud.
Good
strong
idea.
Strong ropes were fastened to his back end. James and Henry, pulling hard, managed to bring him to safety.
You'd think after this he learned his lesson. He did a little bit, but then, you know, a couple of years, sometimes you forget about something and, you go back to the way you used to be. It's kind of sad.
Late that night, Gordon crawled home, a sadder and wiser engine.
For now. That was a good episode. Yeah, it was. Not one of Gordon's best moments, but one of his funniest moments. Yeah. What's next, Rainbow Dash? Oh, you're about to see. You're about to see. Our next story is Down the Mine. Oh boy, another historical moment episode. But this time it's Thomas's. Wait a minute. If this is all about Gordon, then why is this one have a Thomas-centered episode in it?
I can't smell a smell.
Because this picks up after Gordon takes a dip.
Grunted Gordon. It must be yours. Not long ago, he had fallen into a dirty ditch. Thomas enjoyed teasing him about it. Annie? Clarabelle? Do you know what I think it is? It's ditch water.
Twilight was around him during that time. She would not be happy with him. She wants him to be a well-behaved engine.
Annie and Clarabelle could hardly believe their ears. He's dreadfully rude. I feel quite ashamed. He's dreadfully rude. And to Thomas they said, "You mustn't be rude. You make us ashamed." But
hey, he's not that rude. Sure, he can be cheeky, but he's not completely, totally off the top rude.
That was funny. That was funny.
Oh yeah? Well, see, it happened to you, Thomas, and then you wonder, and then you'll know how Gordon felt.
Gordon, the big engine. Thomas left the coaches at the station and went off to a mine for some cars. Long ago, miners digging for lead had made tunnels under the ground. Their roofs are strong enough to hold up cars, but not the weight of engines. A large notice warns them not to enter the area. Danger! Engines must not pass this board.
Also known as Danger, do not pass this sign or else.
Silly.
No one listens to that sign, though.
He had already tried to pass it, but had never succeeded.
They think they can be clever and try to go past any danger. Boy, does irony come biting them hard.
Bumping the cars fiercely, he jerked his driver off the footpath and followed them into the siding. Come back! Yelled his driver.
And down he goes. Twilight wouldn't like this at all. No, she wouldn't.
Sunk. And he was. Oh dear, he said, I am a silly engine. And a very naughty one, too. I saw you, said Sir Topham Hatt. Please get me out. I won't do it again.
Busted.
I'm not sure. We can't lift you out with a crane. The ground's not firm enough. Let me see. I wonder if Gordon could pull you out. Yes, sir, said Thomas.
Oh, look at the tears in his eyes. He's actually crying. Poor Thomas. He really does feel very sorry.
Laughed Gordon. What a joke.
Is Gordon laughing just to be mean to him? No, he's laughing because Thomas just now had the same experience. And he feels his pain. Oh, I still feel bad for Thomas.
Strong cables were fastened between the two engines. Are you ready? Heave!
Come on, Big G! Pull!
It was a lot harder than they all thought.
There we go.
At last, Thomas was free. I'm sorry I was cheeky, said Thomas. That's all right, Thomas. You made me laugh, replied Gordon. I'm in disgrace. So am I, said Thomas.
Wow.
Why, so you are, Thomas. Shall we form an alliance? You help me and I'll help you. Right, you are.
And as we all know, this leads to Thomas meets the Queen. You know, yeah.
And buffer to buffer,
I just wish that allowance lasted for the last 73 years. Yeah, in the spirit of honesty, me too. Well, that was another great story, even though it was Thomas-centered. Well, remember, this took place after Gordon takes a dip. Oh, right. Sorry, I keep forgetting. I do like that story, though. Me too. What's our next story, Rainbow Dash? Oh, you'll soon see, Rainbow Swirl. The next story is...